So yeah, I want to talk about the UX developer. Tom mentioned it in his keynote, and at Dockyard we actually have that role. So yeah, I'll tell you a little bit more about it. So first of all, most of us are probably either full stack or JavaScript engineers, and JavaScript engineers are really bad at HTML and CSS. Seriously, like, probably everyone can write HTML and CSS, but write proper HTML and CSS, and it's a whole different ballgame. Most people think, like, HTML and CSS is easy. It's not. It's often an afterthought. Like, yes, I built this app, and then I'll throw in some HTML and CSS, and then, yeah. But HTML and CSS is actually really hard to get right. Make your app maintainable, do like make your app pretty and usable. Because your CSS often ends up being a bowl of spaghetti, and good luck like maintaining that. And Ember is also pretty hard, so learning Ember and proper CSS and proper HTML, like that's just mind blown. Like, try to like remember all of that. So, yeah, I'll tell you a little bit like how Dockyard like built studio apps for Netflix, and we're hiring, of course. So, our team is a little over 30 people right now, and of that are 10 designers, 14 engineers, 8 UX developers, and a few project managers. And I'll start with like the designer role. So the designer role transforms the ideas from like the stakeholder into mockups. They do the discovery and all that stuff. And they maintain the application style guide. So how the look and feel of the app must be and things like that. Then we have the UX developers, and their responsibility is maintaining a semantic HTML structure. They curate the CSS according to the latest standards. But they are also a bridge between the design, the designers and the engineers. But most of all, they ensure that our apps are accessible. So all the apps we build try to be as accessible as possible, and they are really specialists at that. And if I had to learn Ember and HTML CSS and also learn about all the accessibility stuff, I probably would go crazy. And then we as engineers just barge in and implement the business logic, and they ask us to make the static HTML that the UX developers create dynamic, so that basically like they put up an PR and riddle it with to-do engineering, and then they tell us like if this element is selected, then there needs to happen something, or apply a class, or things like that, and they actually just write Ember templates and build all the stuff in our Ember repo. So yeah, we get along pretty well, and yeah, that's about my lightning talk. So